Good morning students. So now today we are going to start our next chapter, and that is chapter number 6, My Childhood. And this chapter is written by, this story is written by APJ Abdul Kalam. This is an extract which has been taken from Wings of Fire. Now introduction of the chapter. Abdul Kalam's biography is titled Wings of Fire, and the chapter My Childhood talks about the childhood of APJ Abdul Kalam. He was the president of India and a great scientist too. APJ talks about his upbringing, his parents and siblings. He tells us about his friends and all those things that influenced his childhood. Now, explanation of the chapter. So, I was born into a middle-class Tamil family in an island town of Rameshwaram in the erstwhile Madras estate. APJ Abdul Kalam was born into a middle-class Tamil family, and his place of birth, Rameshwaram, is an island town in the state of Tamil Nadu in the Bay of Bengal. Today, we know this state as Tamil Nadu, but when he was born, at that time, the state was known as Madras State. So, this you can see in the picture. My father, Jainulabuddin, had neither much formal education nor much wealth. Despite these disadvantages, he possessed great innate wisdom and a true generosity of spirit. Innate means inborn, a quality of feeling. In one's nature, generosity of spirit, his soul sought to help others who were needy. So he was very generous. He was very, he just took pity on every person. APJ Abdul Kalam's father, so the picture you can see, was Jainulabuddin Abdul. Says that his father was not very rich, he didn't have wealth, he was not highly educated, but despite these disadvantages, he had some other qualities. He was naturally very wise and was generous too. He had an ideal helpmate in my mother, Ashyama. So what was the name of the mother? Ashyama. APJ's mother's name was Ashyama. She used to help his father. She was a great support and help to him. Now APJ's mother was also generous and kind-hearted. Every day she used to feed a lot of people. She fed a greater number of people from outside than the total number of members in their family. Now words meaning you can see in between, and you have to write all words meaning from those words which are written in blue, those all words meaning you have to write in your notebook. Okay, now Abdul Kalam had many siblings, and he describes himself that he had short height and common looks. He didn't have any exceptional looks. On the contrary, his parents were very tall and handsome. They were good looking. APJ didn't inherit their physical qualities. Now, Pakka house means a house made of bricks, cement and limestones. Abdul Kalam's ancestral house was very old. It was built in the 19th century. It was a Pakka house which was made of bricks and limestones. It is located on the Mosque Street in Rameshwaram. Austere, simple, strict and severe, secure, safe, materially means in terms of things like clothes, foods, medicine, emotionally means in terms of love and affection. APJ's father was very simple, but he was strict also. He wanted to live his life in a simple way, and he used to teach his children not to waste money on unnecessary things. APJ says that his father used to avoid any kind of inessential comfort and luxuries. He provided them all the necessary things like food, clothes, medicines. APJ says that his parents fulfilled all his needs, whether it was very tangible thing or their love and affection. This shows that he has the quality of gratitude. APJ is thankful to his parents for whatever they did for him. Now, APJ was 8 years old when the Second World War broke in the year 1939. So, in the year 1939, he was 8 years old. So, we can calculate that he was born in the year 1931. Now, tamarind seeds, kinds of fruit, princely sum, generous amount. Here, ironic, okay. Ana, an old Indian coin worth about 6 paise. The demand for tamarind seeds increased in the market. APJ used to collect and sell the tamarind seeds to a provisional shop located on Mosque Streets. He would earn a mere sum of 1 ana, which equals 6 paise, when he addresses it as a princely sum. Means very he was feeling very wealthy when he was earning. He would earn when he dresses it, we were here, okay, sometimes very great and valuable. It is being ironical as the amount was very meager, okay, at that time. This one ana means a lot of money to him. Now, Dinamani, a Tamil daily newspaper. APJ Abdul Kalam's brother-in-law Jalaluddin used to tell him the stories of the ongoing world war. Later, APJ used to read the newspaper Dinamani and used to look for the news of the same stories. Isolated, lonely or cut off, elite forces, the armies of UK, USA and Russia during the Second World War. Rameshwaram was a small island town far away from land, so it was not affected by the World War in the beginning. But after some time, India had to join the war and combined with the allied forces. Then a state of emergency was declared in the country. During emergency, the president's rule is implemented in the country. It is like a curfew in the country. A lot of privileges which were given to the people are withdrawn at that time. Now, casualty, loss, suspension and halt, stop. The first impact of World War II on the people of the Rameshwaram was the cancellation of the train stoppage at the Rameshwaram station. Earlier, the train which came from India used to stop at Rameshwaram station and then went further to Dhanushkodi. But now, the halt was cancelled and the train went from India to Dhanushkodi without stopping at Rameshwaram. With this, the newspaper bundle which used to come for Rameshwaram was thrown out of the moving train as it reached Rameshwaram Road. Now, fills the slot, fit into a space easily. APJ Abdul Kalam's cousin Samsuddin used to distribute the newspapers in Rameshwaram as the train stoppage was cancelled and the newspaper bundle was thrown out of the moving train. He needed someone to help him catch it. APJ Abdul Kalam, Samsuddin, by catching the bundle and distributing the newspapers, in returning, Samsuddin paid him a salary which was APJ's first earning. Now, pride. Sudden increase in the feeling of satisfaction derived from one's own achievements. Half a century later means after a period of 50 years. The incident happened 50 years ago. Even now, that is, when he wrote the book, he couldn't feel satisfied and proud of himself. APJ says that whenever someone earns his own money with his hard work, he feels it the same way as he did. Okay, figure of authority, a person who had authority over another person, a person who has the power of give orders to make decisions. Inherited means that is actually the characteristics or the quality which any person have got from their parent or ancestors. Social economic means here in terms of money, socio economic in terms of money. For a child, the figure of authority is his parents and the next figure of authority can be his teacher. A person who has authority over the child, APJ is saying that whenever a child is born, he has some quality which he acquires from the elders in his family. These depend upon the social status of the family and the environment at home. From his father, he inherited honesty and self-discipline, and from his mother he inherited faith in goodness and deep kindness. His siblings also inherited these qualities from their parents. Orthodox means strict. APJ had three best friends during his childhood. Their names are Ramanath Shastri, Arvind Arvindan and Shiv Prakashan. All of them belonged to very strict Hindu Brahmin families and were ardent followers of their religion. As Abdul Kalam was from a Muslim family, he says that during his childhood, all children were so close to each other that they never felt that belonged to different religions. Religion was not a barrier in their friendship. There is a very famous temple in Rameshwaram, the Rameshwaram temple. APJ's best friend Ramanad Shastri was the son of Pakshi Lakshman Shastri, the priest of this temple. When these three friends grew up, Ramanad Shastri took the priesthood of the Rameshwaram temple. Arvindan started a business of transporting the pilgrims to and from the Rameshwaram temple, and Shiv Prakashan became a catering contractor for the Southern Railway. He was in charge of the catering for the railway. Now, meanings, words meaning you can see here. Okay. Whenever the Sri Sita Raman Kalyanam, Kalyanam means the marriage, okay, ceremony used to take place, APJ's family also took part in it. They used to arrange the boats for it. They used to make a special platform on the boats on which the statue of Ram and Sita were placed and transported from the temple to the marriage site, which was in the temple of a pond named Rama. Okay, Rama Tirth. This pond was near APJ's house. When he was growing up, he never thought that there was any difference between Hindu and Muslims, as they participated in the Hindu festivals wholeheartedly. Okay. Now, events from the Ramayana and from the life of the grandmother would tell the children in our family. Okay, so they were telling the stories. APJ says that they listened to stories from the Ramayana and the life of the prophet from their mother and grandmother as bedtime stories. So they listened to stories of both Hindu gods and Muslim gods. There was no differentiation on ground of religion. Now, as APJ Abdul Kalam belonged to a Muslim family, he used to wear a cap on his head, which identified him as a Muslim. His friends Ramanad Shastri, who was the son of the priest of Rameshwaram temple, belonged to a Hindu Brahmin family and used to wear the sacred thread worn by Brahmins. Okay, so this you can see the thread. This is what जिसे हम जनेऊ भी बोलते हैं. Okay, so the Brahmins used to wear that and the Muslim used to wear a white cap or the cap. Okay. This new teacher, now what happened there? As APJ Abdul Kalam belonged to Muslim family, so this the sacred thread worn by Brahmins. When these children were in the class 5, a new teacher came to their class. APJ Abdul Kalam recalls an incident which happened then. So what was the incident? This new teacher could not tolerate that a Hindu priest's son was sitting next to a Muslim boy. He told a lower rank of the he told APJ to go and sit on the last bench as he belonged to a lower rank of the society. Both the children felt very bad when APJ changed his seat and went back and sat on the last bench. Ramanath felt very bad. APJ still remembers the image of his friend Ramanad crying. It left a lifelong impression on Kalam of his friend's feelings for him. Now, both children went home and told their parents about this incident, and Ramanad's father, Lakshman Shastri, called the new teacher and scolded him. He told him not to kill the children's friendship by putting the venomous discrimination of caste and religion into their innocent minds. Lakshmana Shastri was very clear in himself. He told the teacher, either you ask sorry for the wrong you have done, or else leave the school and Rameshwaram town also. The teacher asked sorry for the mistake he had done, and due to Lakshmana Shastri's determination, his thoughts about religion and caste changed. The division of society into four groups, Brahmins, Kshatriya, Vaishyas and Shudras, was strictly followed in the Rameshwaram. Okay, Abdul Kalam's science teacher, Shri Shiv Subramaniam Iyer was a religious person, an orthodox Brahmin, but was a very rebellious type of person. He did not believe in distinction on the basis of the caste system. He worked very hard to break these social barriers. He wanted that people of different castes should interact with each other. He encouraged APJ Abdul Kalam to work hard so that he could be at the same level as the highly educated people who lived in big cities. Now, ritually pure, kept protected from all outside influence for the observances of religion. Perchaped upset. Now, Shiv Subramaniam Iyer's wife belonged to a traditional and orthodox Brahmin family. She followed the religion very strictly, and to keep the kitchen pure, no one from an inferior religion was allowed to enter the kitchen. When Shiv Subramaniam Iyer called Abdul Kalam for dinner at his home, his wife feared that a boy from a Muslim family would make her kitchen impure. She refused to serve him food in her kitchen. Shiv Subramaniam Iyer was neither upset nor angry. He himself served food to APJ and sat down beside him to eat. His wife stood beside the kitchen door and looked at APJ while he was having food. APJ says that he doesn't think that she felt there was any difference in the way he was having his food, or the way he was drinking water, or in the way he cleans the floor after the meal. He wants to highlight that religion doesn't matter, as it doesn't alter the way in which a person eats food. Hesitation. This is hesitation means doubt, delay, confronted, faced, or tackled. When APJ was about to leave Shiv Subramaniam Iyer's house, he invited him for dinner once again. When Shiv Subramaniam Iyer saw that APJ Abdul Kalam was seethed, he asked him not to be upset. He added that if he had decided to change the system, to go against the norms of the society, he had to be strong and brave and confront the situation. When he visited Shiv Subramaniam's home for dinner the next week, his wife made him sit in the kitchen and served food with her own hands. This is the change that happened. Now, when the Second World War got over in the year 1945, India was about to get freedom, which happened in the year 1947. M.K. Gandhi, known as the father of the nation, was a crucial part of India's freedom struggle. He said that Indians would build their own India. The entire country was filled with hope and happiness. Everyone was experiencing such a feeling which they had never felt before. Everyone was hoping that now they would get their freedom. APJ asked his father to allow him to go to Ramanathapuram, which was the distinct headquarter for higher studies. So Sigul is a board study for it. In reply, his father told him that he knew that APJ needed to go away so that he could move ahead in life. He gave the example of a seagull, which is a bird, okay, which flies away in the sky all alone and does not have a nest. It means it doesn't have a home of its own, as it keeps on flying from one place to another. Now, when APJ's mother came to know that he was about to leave home and wanted to go to Ramanathapuram for higher studies, she got upset. APJ's father tried to calm her down and told her a few lines from a famous poem titled Your Children, written by Khalil Gibran. He said that your children are not your children, they are the children of life. Don't think that you can rule your children, they are a result of life's desire for itself. They have their own thoughts. He asked her to give them freedom to fulfill their thoughts. Now, this was the poem, I mean this chapter. Now, question answers you can see. Okay, where was Abdul Kalam's house? Abdul Kalam's house was located on the Mosque Street in the town of Rameshwaram in Tamil Nadu. Okay, question number 2. What do you think Dinamani is the name of. Give a reason for your answer. Dinamani is the name of a newspaper. It is vernacular daily printed in Tamil Nadu, Tamil language. I think so because Kalam says that he praised the stories of the war in the headlines of the Dinamani. Who were Abdul Kalam's school friends? What did they later became? During his childhood, Abdul Kalam had three friends. Their names were Ramanath Shastri, Arvindan and Shiv Prakashan. When they grew, Ramanath Shastri became the priest of the Rameshwaram temple. Arvindan started a business of transporting pilgrims to and from the Rameshwaram temple, and Shiv Prakashan became a caterer for the railways. How did Abdul Kalam earn his first wages? Abdul Kalam earned his first wages by catching the bundle of newspaper thrown out of the moving train at the Rameshwaram station. He helped his cousin in distributing newspapers in Rameshwaram. Had he earned any money before that? In what way? When the Second World War started, there was a great demand for tamarind seeds. Kalam would collect them and sell them to a grocery store located on Mosque Street. He would earn an anna, which was a meager sum, but for him it was a handsome sum of money. Now this is answer in short. Okay, you can see here. Now remaining, you can see, so these you have to do in your notebook. Just have a look. All right, in the same way as these are done, you have to do in your notebook. Okay, so now complete your work. All right, and send to me so that I can check. Okay, now complete your work. Thank you so much for watching. I hope everybody has understood this chapter. Thank you.